What's very interesting is the connection between iodine deficiency and breast health. And if we look at Japanese women who historically have known to have very low rates of breast cancer, they do consume a very high iodine-containing diet. So the Japanese women typically will eat a lot of seaweed and a lot of seafood as well, and it's been observed that because of their very low rates of breast disease, this is definitely one of the factors. So in our history of iodine deficiency, this is something that, if you are aware, different parts of the world definitely have lower levels of iodine naturally occurring. So the more inland you are, I did a whole show on iodine deficiency, so you can check it out here on YouTube. But if we are more inland and you live more inland, of course, away from the sea and the seafood and the sea air, then this will definitely put you at more of a risk of an iodine deficiency. So some people are more at risk of an iodine deficiency than others if you have exposure to the other halogens. So things like chlorine, bromine, fluoride, these will displace the iodine because they're preferential in our metabolism over the iodine, and the iodine can very easily be displaced, therefore putting the breast tissue and the thyroid as well at risk for that iodine deficiency and decreased normal function. So this is something that we definitely want to ensure that we're getting enough healthy iodine from whole food sources in our diet. And we want to avoid any of those halogens, so things like bromide. And there's a very popular, which a lot of people don't realize, a very popular caffeinated lemon lime soda out there, which does contain brominated vegetable oil. And this is to help with those citrus ingredients, to help them from separating and going to the top of the can or the bottle. So look out for this. If you do drink, you know, soda pops and this lemon lime one that does have caffeine, I'm not going to name what the name brand is, look out for that ingredient, the brominated vegetable oil on the labels. Definitely something you do not want to be ingesting, especially if there are concerns about breast health, which I think most of us don't want to ever develop any type of breast problem. Now, in this study, it's interesting because in 1993, a Canadian study was done that found that iodine replacement was very helpful in fibrocystic breast disease. So in 74%, so a huge percentage of the patients in this crossover series had clinical improvement, and objective improvement was noted in 72% of those who received the molecular iodine. So if you do have fibrocystic breasts, painful breasts, it may be telling you that you do have an iodine deficiency. So do make sure you check out my other YouTube videos on iodine deficiency and why it's so important that we are making sure that we get enough from a whole food form every single day. So today I talked all about the connections between iodine deficiency and breast health. I hope that you've got some questions or comments for me. Please put them in the comment section below. Be sure to share this video as well and give me a big thumbs up. If you're new to my channel, welcome in. Please subscribe and hit that bell. Turn on those post notifications so that you are always notified of my newest and latest uploads. Everyone does have a calling in life, and mine is to empower you to live a healthy lifestyle and, of course, to do it naturally. Thanks for watching.